Let's find out what went wrong. As usual, looking at a graph clarifies a lot. In the picture, you see the graph of the left-hand side of the inequality, y equals 1 over x squared minus 1, in blue, and the graph of the right-hand side, the horizontal line, y equals 1, in green. The solutions to this inequality lie in the intervals where the blue graph is above the green one. Remember, the boundaries of these intervals can be points at which both sides are equal, that is, where the graphs intersect, but also at points where one of the functions is not defined or discontinuous. And now you can see what went wrong. When we tried to solve the inequality, we found the x values where the graphs intersect, but we forgot that the left-hand side is not defined at two points on the real line. That really matters here. You see that at these points, the inequality holds on one side, but not on the other. And you can see this clearly in the graph. We relied on the graph here, but sometimes sketching the graph is not an option, because it is too difficult. But in fact, you don't need graphs, as long as you keep the following in mind. Given an inequality, you must find the x values where both sides are equal. In this case, x is equal to minus the square root of 2, and x is equal to the square root of 2. But also find the x values where the functions involved are not defined or discontinuous. In this case, this happens at x is equal to minus 1 and x is equal to 1, since the denominator of the left-hand side of the inequality is 0 there. These four points then divide the real line into five intervals. On each interval, either the inequality holds for all points or for none of them. And you can simply check at one point in each interval whether the inequality holds or not. Since we have a graph, it's even easier to tell where the inequality holds. At the intervals, minus the square root of 2 to minus 1, and 1 to the square root of 2.